Also, St. Paul is loved to mention eye contact. Jane Austen wrote in her famous book Pride and Prejudice that Darcy found Elizabeth hardly had a good feature in her face, but it was rendered uncommonly intelligent by the beautiful expression of her dark eyes. Scientists have also been studying eye contact for years. They think evolution has actually selected us with the ability to use eye contact in communication and social interactions. Animals living in jungles or trees don't need many visual signals. Jungles are often dark with leaves blocking sunlight and visions, so they mainly use sound or smell as signals. Animals living in small groups also don't need many visual cues. They don't have much computation, so there's no need for high-level social skills. Humans, on the contrary, live on land and have much larger populations than other species. The problem with large populations is a fierce competition for all kinds of resources. That's why we need more ways in communication and cooperation to avoid killing each other. Among the many primate species studied by scientists, humans are the only one that have white
sclera,
generally known as the white of the eye. Scientists think this facilitates the use of eye contact because we can easily distinguish between direct gaze, which is a signal of paying attention, from averted gaze, or gaze to one side. A study of infants also found out when babies were presented with images of faces, their brains were much more active when seeing the images of direct gaze than those of averted gaze. We can easily understand why babies react when they see a dog or even a mouse, because these are large moving objects in their eyes. But why did the slight difference of the position of eyes, two dots, cause the babies to react so differently? Scientists use EEG techniques to detect brain activities of infants during the experiment, and recorded a component called N170. The N170 component is found both in adults and 6-month-old infants, and has been shown to be sensitive to faces. This has provided strong evidence for the idea that the ability to use eye contact in social interactions is very likely a result of evolution. So next time, before you worry about your social skills, just get out and talk to someone first. Remember to use eye contact as long as the culture allows.